I've been working hard for Omega. I've been working hard on the line.
I'm Brandon Myers, the president of the Tom Data Chapter here in East Illinois of Omega Psi Phi Project Incorporated. I'm also the second vice district representative of the Talented Tech District, which oversees Minnesota, Michigan, Indiana, Illinois, and Wisconsin. I'm also on the International Committee of the Youth Leadership Committee, and I'm also on the District Committee for the Chief. And I live with a single mother, and she's kind of been my best friend throughout these years. My father was incarcerated when I was younger, so I was pretty much the man that I had. Up to my grandfather, he was my father figure in my earlier years, but he died when I was 7. So after that, I kind of just veered off and overcome. But I got into certain social vices. After a while, I honestly felt, I knew in my heart that I wanted to do better. I was a smart kid. I was student council. I made the honor roll multiple times. But it was times that I did do bad. I mean, I had a couple Fs and fighting and stuff like that. You can just kind of see when these things are repetitive and you start to see how it kind of hurts your family, you got to take heed to that. But still, I was kind of indulging into the streets and wasn't fully focused. I even got stabbed once when I was up in high school. I got jumped, broke 3 ribs while playing. It was just a lot of influence. Like I said, sometimes it's hard to overcome, even though you try through hard work and stuff like that. Sometimes that pressure, it kind of is hard to overcome. During university, during my sophomore year of East Illinois, I was actually shot twice in my stomach, doing stuff that I wasn't supposed to. Pretty much seen it all. I done seen people die in my face, family members pass. I done seen people kick down doors. I done seen people get robbed in broad daylight. And honestly, when you're living in the inner city of Chicago, it's kind of normal. Don't really hurt. Sometimes I would say some people don't hurt when they hear about other people passing away. To me, it did. And I kind of think that's what the difference between me and a lot of people was. And I was still well-respected, primarily because of who I was, who my people were, what I had done. But I still wanted something different. Visually, you want to do better because you see that they had a certain amount of potential and they didn't fulfill that. And I wanted to exceed my potential because I knew I was smart. And I knew I was intelligent, and I seen those social vices, and I wanted to make a difference. Actually led me to Omega. My best friend, he's like a brother to me, his name is Alante Johnson. His father was a man of Omega. And his father was always a father figure to me, when my father was incarcerated. So many different prominent people during that era was accused. And I mean, I'm only a year and a half in playing to you those individuals, the prominent men, the Carter G. Woodsons of the world, who was also accused. So I was in good company. I didn't really indulge in the status quo or persona of Omega. I knew that I was in great company. And that's how I proceeded when I entered the folds of Omega. So like I said, when I went into Omega, my first objective was to make sure that my chapter was back active. Well, I solved that. I became a second vice district representative, the third in charge of the district. So you got a person that's right on your guard that knows exactly what the district is doing, when it's intake, when it's policies, bylaws, audits. I do all of that. Why wouldn't you want to be a part of that? Why wouldn't you want to be a part of that? That's greatness.